Hi guys, we're now doing another drawing prompt. Today I am drawing a chair. So this is the chair I'm picking. So I'm going to get started. So I got my stuff ready to go. Alright, so I'm going to draw a bunch of chairs on this side and try to do the finishing product on this side. So, looking at the picture, looks like an easy, simple chair, so I'm trying to do my best. Now, like I said, I'm not very good at inanimate objects, but I'll try my best. And you gotta remember, like, one side is closer to the other. It's how it sits. You kinda wanna go at an angle. And I haven't really drawn chairs before, so this should be interesting. Does help looking at a picture for me. That looks pretty good. And then looks like this one comes up here. Goes down. And that's why I kind of go at an angle, because you have to do the angles on this. It's like the optical illusion. You've got to make sure it kind of looks like the object, but kind of, you know, your own spin and take. Might be a little bit smaller, actually. I'm kind of a perfectionist when it comes to my art. I kind of want it to look a certain way. And I keep seeing my pencil move. I'm trying to go back to the mechanical pencil. I'm going to have to break this. Break the tip and... And I think I want to bring this down just a little bit more. Up a little bit higher, just a tad. Let's see here. We're going to do the inside here. Probably can make that smaller. It's not gonna look exactly like the picture, but it's gonna be very, very close. Looks like there is a part here. Got a little more angle. Maybe make this one smaller. This kind of goes like an angle. I'm gonna erase that. This one kind of goes up. Yeah. know. That's my first year. So, and see, I made the base a little too wide, but I want it like a side square. Trying to go with angles here. See, I remember my mom's and dad's table that we had growing up was all wooden. Actually, my grandmother had the same set. And I'm actually sitting, that is one of my chairs that I'm using to sit in as I'm doing this video. Ooh, I kind of like that. That looks really cool. I might do it at this angle. Kind of like that. And maybe a small piece right there. This is where I want to do more of an angle. Give that a little, it's not working too well. I think that was a good idea to actually start. Start with the base, select the seeding area. I kind of like that. So I am gonna start doing my chair. Kind of face it around this one. Maybe make the legs a little bit longer. So make sure I'm gonna switch to a mechanical pencil because that one is driving me nuts. And I don't need my pencil sharpener for now. So, like I said, I want to do the base first, like the sitting area. I'm gonna out all my corners. I'm actually starting to like this challenge. This challenge is brought to you by Tradabug, which I just got off. But I saw that I might reinstate myself for next month so I can see the drone prompts. I love, because this actually, I'm a creative person, but sometimes it's hard to come up with things to draw. And I actually like these pencils. And again, these are ink soft. And these are 0.71. I found these at the Dollar Tree. They're very nice to hold, just in case you wonder what kind of pen I have. I had this for I don't know how many years. These are very good erasers. I actually have a big, huge pack. I mean, just remember, but I did buy those packs from Dollar Tree to make the stick the ends if I needed to. I'm kind of going at an angle because this is actually more of a wood chair that I'm creating. Go the other way. Hmm. actually looks pretty good for my first leg. You can also use a ruler if you need to. But you don't want, you want kind of at an angle. That might be too much of an angle on that foot. This is what the ruler would come in handy. That looks pretty good. That actually looks really good. Help, I think, with the angles right now. Because we need that to go that way. We don't have to go that way. And then probably. I kinda messed up a little bit. Well, that's okay. I'm gonna use the ruler. It tends to help a little bit when coming to excuse me. Not liking where this feet are. Side more. I'm gonna have it come. That could be that one. That looks better. Oh my God, this looks so much right. Oh, look at that. That looks amazing. Oh, that like stressed me out a little bit. So now I'm going to kind of use the same charcoal pencil, the 4B. I thought that was very good with yesterday's drawing, the blending tool. And then I'm going to use those two colors that I used yesterday, which I thought were pretty good. The dark brown and the light brown. I think those work really good. These are Crayola color pencils. Just in case you're wondering. So now that I got that, now I can lightly erase everything. We can still kind of see watercolor and kind of go over that coloring. And then I'm going to go into detail with darkening, doing some highlights. I'm gonna kind of go over a little bit of my lines. I can kind of see them. Hold on, somebody is texting me. I gotta answer them. Tell them I'm gonna know now right now. Almost done, and I don't want to stop my video. Oh my god, this is going to be so cool looking. Can't wait. I do like how this turned out, like drawing lines. It was kind of a good idea to use the ruler to, so that's what I got so far. Take a fine liner and go around the edges. That might be cool. This would have been cool in a color, watercolor too. like how I did the shadowing a little bit. I'm unhappy. Now I can you gotta figure out where you want your inner colors, and then you wanna darken it up at too. I like going over it with a little bit of a darker brown, too. I guess I'll have to share this a little bit more. Alright. So now we're gonna really take our blending to clean it up just a little bit by using broom. Replenish the line. I hope you enjoyed that. Let me just do one last thing. Date it for today. It's Tuesday. I'm actually doing two videos today. Yesterday. So if you're watching this, you already saw the one video that I already did. I really, really enjoyed this. I hope you did too. So that's the final product. So you saw yesterday teacup. Today was chair. So until tomorrow, have a wonderful day and be safe. Peace out.